Hi, good morning. Brand new day, very cooling, but very sunny. I'm now at this temple in Ubon Ratchathani. This temple name is called Wat Thai Phrat Chau Yai Ong Thu. So basically, this is a history. The temple is actually joined by two temples. Okay, and from two villages. So they decided to use the name as a common name for both temple as Wat Thai. And this place used to be a meditation temple for this Prat Achan Sao, Kanta Silo, and Prat Achan Man. Like this. And then they have the Buddha image here. They put in sizes. Sizes is in inches. 51 inch lap width, 85 inch height. And then there's no actual record who is the maker, when this temple started and all that. But they record that this Prat Achan Sao and Prat Achan Man come here for meditation. And then this Prat Chau Ong Thu, only five in the world. One is in here, Wat Thai. Second one in Chiang Mai, I think is Wat Suan Dok. I've been there before in my last trip. And then Wat Chaya Peng in the Chaya Peng and Nong Khai. And then Wat Prato Na Tan district in Ubon. And then another one in Laos. So I think the one in Ubon is here. Let's have a look. This is the temple, how it looks like. Wat Thai from the outside, from the main road. Very, very near to my hotel. Only very quiet street in the early morning on a Saturday. So this manor we can see, this is the entrance of the temple. We actually park at the other temple over there in Wat Liap, then walk over. I think it's easier. I think temple now is doing a lot of renovation. So this is how the temple ground look like inside. There's also some parking space here, but not that many. So my suggestion, you can try to park at Wat Liap, that is opposite only, and then cross a small road and then come over. A lot of work there is just seems like going on. This is the Ubosot lah. Yeah, now we are going in to have a look. So this is the image of Prat Chau Ong Thu. Then this is also the area for monk to do Sankathan. There's a mural all around here. Very quiet, very peaceful temple. There's many Buddha images. Surrounding the perimeters of the temple itself. So now we are going to one looks like a pagoda to me. I'm not sure what is inside there. Looks like a Chinese temple style, but I think it's still Thai Buddha inside. Let's go have a look. This is a very steep staircase. So we got to slowly climb up and see what is inside. Wow, inside is many Buddha image. And I think they have a lot of relics as well. See? Maybe it's a museum. From here, the top, you can see the temple. Perth itself, I think far end there should be the big this Buddha image of Pak Chok Ong Tsu. Now we are going to go over there. I think this sala is where the monk do their work most of the time. This is another sala. Them monk doing some work here. There's many images of monk and the Buddha over here, and I think there's a lot of nut frogs here. Now we are going to another sala. Very very big temple, and every inch of the temple it seems to be fully built up and then properly maintained. There's one. Hello. There's one monk there. Now we are going to go up here into the sala. Wow. This sala is very big. I think it's for the events. Now we're going to go in to have a look at the Buddha. Very unique. Very beautiful, the way they lay out. Very special. Here should be for the VIP. Maybe a king, or maybe some senior monk to do the chanting. So we managed to speak to one monk. He's telling us that this temple only have one 7 monks and then 5 novices, so total 12. So basically this temple across the road is a white titan, and then this the Pak Chok Ong Tsu, and then the Wat Liep where I parked the car. These 3 temples used to be one temple last time, but due to the construction of the roads are cutting through, right? They have to segregate this one whole temple, become 3 separate temples. And then these 3 separate temples is being taken care by these 7 monks and 5 novices. Yeah, and then this temple, Pak Chok Ong Tsu temple, is actually the place where Pak Ajahn Sao become novice. Pak Ajahn Sao is actually the master of Ajaman, that is. Okay, now we are going to see this big golden Buddha. It's Longpo To. And then there's another white Buddha called Longpo Khao. Very famous. The white Buddha is Longpo Khao. The gold color is Longpo To. Very, very famous old Buddha in Thailand. After checking with the monk, we know this one is Longpo Du Awasake, famous for make the flood prone one. After Longpo Si Awasake, same. So I think the Sawat here, Longpo Sawat, this disciple of Longpo Du. Temple also have the Tao Isu one for praying by everyone. And then this is Longpo Khao. Yeah, Longpo Khao. Very famous. First time saw it is in Wat Thep Pithat Phunaram in Pak Chong. So after talking to the monk, we also found out many things like the Longpo Du Awasake. And then this Longpo Sao, Ajahn Sao. Master of Longpo Man, and also the history of this temple. So I think it's really interesting. Many things we got to know from here. I think it's a very very good trip to me, if you ask me. Yeah. So I think really.